We finally got the full trailer for Ahsoka today, and it looks spectacular. I'm sure you want to hear about it as much as I want to talk about it, so let's dispense with the pleasantries and dive right in. The trailer opens with a shot of an Eta-class ambassadorial shuttle approaching a New Republic capital ship. This marks the Eta's first live-action appearance, and it looks fantastic. The ship is being flown by the apparent antagonists of this season: Baylan Skoll, played by the late Ray Stevenson, and Shin Hati, played by Ivana Sakno. This already tells us something interesting about Baylan. The Eta-class shuttle was primarily used by the Jedi. Baylan is a Force user and knew Anakin Skywalker somehow, meaning that he must have been a Jedi who left the Order during the Clone Wars, stealing this shuttle in the process. Now he has a Padawan of his own in Shin, and they are up to no good. The crew of the New Republic ship allow them to land, thinking they are Jedi, but Baylan reveals to them and to us that they are not, and he and Shin go on a rampage throughout the ship in an extended version of the sequence we saw in the teaser a few months ago. We don't know yet what this will accomplish, but it can't be good. Perhaps they are trying to free Thrawn's associate, Morgan Elsbeth, who we see them with later in the trailer. We get a repeat of Ahsoka's line about Thrawn returning as heir to the Empire before we see Baylan and Shin approaching some kind of mysterious site. A lot of fans believed this to be the World Between Worlds when it briefly appeared in the teaser, but we see it more clearly in this trailer, and it appears to be some kind of navigation tool that will help them find Thrawn. It reminds me of an ancient real-world astronomical device called an astrolabe, so that's what I will call it. Shin asks what happens when they find him, and Baylan answers, "Power, such as you've never dreamed," as Morgan Elsbeth activates the device. We're learning a lot about our villains in this trailer. It seems like the show is going to be a race between Ahsoka's team and Baylan's team to find Thrawn. Ahsoka wants to stop him, and Baylan wants to join him. I believe Baylan wants him and Shin to be the Darth Vaders to Thrawn's Emperor Palpatine, and the astrolabe will lead him to them. We then see a gorgeous shot of the New Republic fleet with an MC-80 class cruiser flanked by corvettes, frigates, and several of the new ship that we saw Team Baylan assault earlier. Hera is there, in a conference call with several important New Republic politicians, including Mon Mothma. She is trying to convince them to help search for and fight a rising threat, presumably Thrawn. She is apparently unsuccessful, but she sends Ahsoka to seek out Sabine Wren on Lothal. It is revealed that Sabine spent some time training with Ahsoka, but they had some kind of falling out and haven't been in contact since. I've seen a bit of debate online if this means that Sabine is a Force user, and while I think that this is very much a possibility, and that there were even very subtle hints that this could be the case in Rebels and later in this trailer, I think it's more likely that it was purely lightsaber training. Sabine possessed the Darksaber for a short time and inherited Ezra's lightsaber after he went missing with Thrawn, so she probably just needed more training on that. We later see Shin shout at her that she has no power, which I interpret as meaning she doesn't possess the power of the Force. Sabine is involved in some kind of speeder bike chase against an E-Wing, which looks absolutely fantastic in its live-action debut. I can't stress enough how beautiful everything in this trailer is. This starfighter is from the Legends continuity and appeared in several books and comics there, but has only had a couple of Easter egg level nods in canon so far, so it is great to see this ship featured so prominently. There is a bit of dialogue between Hera and Ahsoka about Sabine, and some between Ahsoka and Sabine about her training, and then we see Sabine in Ezra's apartment, watching a holo recording of him encouraging her to do something, presumably continue the fight against tyranny in his absence, or something along those lines. She dons her Mandalorian armor and cuts her hair short, and we get a brief but very cool recreation of the end scene of Rebels with Sabine and Ahsoka reuniting in front of Sabine's mural of the Ghost Crew. It's really cool to see this in live action, especially because they actually used the Rebels art style for the mural. I can't wait to see this scene play out. Sabine joins Ahsoka and the ancient Jedi droid Huyang in Ahsoka's T6 Jedi shuttle, and they jump to hyperspace. We get some more shots from the teaser and the Rebels finale recreation, and then we see a brief shot of Sabine manning the tail gun of the shuttle. This and the fourth engine are new additions to the ship for live action, but the shuttle was very bare there in the Clone Wars, so they look great. We then see Shin's starfighter chasing Team Ahsoka through the tentacles of what appears to be a massive Purrgil. I'm very curious about the context of this scene. I'm inclined to think that this will be from late in the season, and they will be approaching Thrawn and or Ezra's location, hence the Purrgil, but we'll have to see. Most of the recent Star Wars trailers have mostly shown scenes from the first half of their respective seasons, but you never know. We then get to see Thrawn in all his glory for the first time. He was shown in the Star Wars Celebration version of the teaser, and leaked images of that have surfaced, but this is the best look we've gotten so far. He looks great. I haven't been mentioning it, but all of the characters do. Ahsoka, Hera, Sabine, Chopper, Hologram Ezra, and Hu Yang all look and sound absolutely perfect. The rest of the trailer is basically a montage of short, unconnected scenes. It cuts to the scene I mentioned between Shin and Sabine. They are dueling in a forest, and Shin taunts her about her lack of power. This is mirrored in the next scene with Baylan and Ahsoka's duel in the Astrolabe, where Baylan reveals that he knew Ahsoka's Jedi Master Anakin, who he says spoke highly of her. To this she replies that she's not there to discuss her past, though I suspect that there will be quite a lot of that indeed this season. There's a very cool shot of Ahsoka running to her ship, away from a massive explosion consuming the ruins we see her exploring in this trailer and the teaser. A few weeks ago I made a video discussing various mechanical details on Star Wars ships, like the thrust reversers on the Invisible Hand and the Razor Crest, so I was pleased to notice that her shuttle is equipped with something that appears to be variable thrust exhaust nozzles on the engines, which fan out to accommodate the ship's low speed. Not important at all to the course of the trailer or the plot of the show, I just thought it was cool. You can check out that video when you're done with this one. We see a sequence of shots with Hu Yang, Hera, Ahsoka, and Sabine in the cockpit of a ship, but I think the three shots are completely independent of one another. Hera appears to be in the Ghost, excitingly, and Sabine and Ahsoka are in the T6. I'm not sure exactly which one Hu Yang is in, but I assume he's in the T6 as well since we see him there with Ahsoka several times throughout the trailer. Hera says, "Once a rebel, always a rebel," which I took to mean that she's been ordered to stay out of this by the New Republic, since she's a general in their navy, and in true Hera fashion, she refuses. We see a brief montage of action scenes, which includes Sabine and Ahsoka beating up Morgan Elsbeth's goons, a space battle between Ahsoka in the T6 and a couple of unidentified starfighters, Hera shooting at someone on what looks like the bridge of a ship, and, most interestingly, the unknown Inquisitor and Ahsoka running directly into blaster fire from Baylan's shuttle. There is also a shot of Ahsoka in the dark forest we've seen several times now, looking thoroughly unimpressed with the Inquisitor's spinning blade before meeting him in battle. Finally, the episode ends with the reveal that the first two episodes will drop on August 23rd. I'm not sure what else there is to say about this trailer other than wow. This show looks like it is going to be incredible, and I can't wait to see it in August. In the meantime, you can look forward to some videos about the ships featured in this trailer. I have one in the works already about the Sheathipede class shuttle, of which the Phantom II we see Hera flying in here is one. I will also have to make one on the T6 and one on the Ada class shuttle. It is very, very intriguing that both the protagonist and antagonist fly antique Jedi shuttles. If any of that interests you, subscribe and stay tuned for those in the coming weeks. If there are any other ships or topics seen in this trailer that you'd like a breakdown of, let me know in the comments, as well as what you are looking forward to most in Ahsoka. Anyway, with that said, I'll see you later. RFC out.